You're the one, yes. Not like the scabs that exited the shuttle with you. You radiate power, Lord. I bow before you. I serve Lord Barriss. He sent me to meet his new apprentice, and I made sure I was here on time. I certainly did, yes indeed.
So, I'm met. Now what?
I'm just a slave who owes his every breath to the tolerance of Lord Barriss. He said to introduce you to Dromund Kaas, and I take that seriously.
You have a strong survival instinct.
Thank you, kind lord. I am seldom referred to as strong. Lord Barriss ordered me to encourage you to explore Kaas City before reporting to him. Imperials maintain the order, but they won't bother you. When you're ready, Lord Barriss will meet you in his personal chambers. You will tell Lord Barriss I was good? Yes? That I served well?
You did exactly what you were told.
You have my thanks, gentle juggernaut. I bow my head until you depart.
Wow, you showed remarkable restraint with him.
We're moving on. Keep up.
So, hey, I've been thinking. Maybe you want to take this shock collar off? You know, as a sign of thanks for my hard work on Korriban. Not that I don't enjoy the perpetual fear of electrocution.
You've earned it, Vet. It is not freedom, though.
Wow. Now I feel stupid for not asking sooner. Don't worry. I'll try not to give you reason to slap that thing back on.
Neither the collar nor your slavery were my idea.
I hear you. Just another day in the life of the Empire, huh? Well, I'm not in prison or collared. And it's sort of miserable weather, so I guess we should... What happens now?
You and me, working together, taking down the galaxy. What do you think?
What? Well... Of course. Me and my buddy, the Sith. Nobody's gonna pick on me at school. Sorry. Let's just get going, yeah?
Not a minute too soon. Your timing is impeccable.
Did it just get considerably colder?
I see you decided to keep the slave. I hope she amuses you. I trust you've been acquainting yourself with your new environs. Did my minion point you in the right direction?
He's a dutiful servant who lives to serve you.
A properly beaten down slave is the only trustworthy creature in the galaxy. Your responsibilities will mandate contact with my various minions. Meet my directives, and you may do as you will to anyone you encounter, adversary or ally.
You can trust that I'll use good judgment, Master.
I have painstakingly built a vast network of spies and operatives embedded throughout the Sith, Republic, and Jedi alike. I have fingers, eyes, and ears everywhere.
Which am I to be? A finger, eye, or ear?
You're my enforcer. Deployed to protect my interests, intimidate my rivals, and destroy my enemies. It's time for your tenure to begin.
A military starship is touching down at the Kaas City cargo port, delivering a vitally important prisoner to me. You will meet Commander Lanklin at Docking Bay 12 and make sure he and his men successfully offload this prisoner.
If you're sending me, you must be expecting trouble.
We must always assume that we are being plotted against, especially when the stakes are high. The importance of this prisoner cannot be overstated. Go to the cargo port now and stay sharp. You are dismissed.
All right, man, let's hurry up and get this hunk of carbonite to its owner.
Hey, Captain Olivius.
Boo.
Oh, I didn't see you enter. Lord Barriss didn't need to send a welcoming party.
You're lucky I'm not an enemy, or you'd all be dead.
Forgive me, my lord, but this is the capital world of the Empire. My men and I have performed much more dangerous duties for Lord Barriss. The prisoner is frozen in carbonite, so he's not a flight risk. And this is friendly territory. Surely we're safe here.
There is no such thing as friendly territory.
No offense, my lord. That brand of paranoia may work for Lord Barriss, but I don't subscribe to it.
When you're on assignment for us, you do.
Yes, my lord. Whatever you say. Let's get this oversized block of ice to your master.
Not so fast. My master ordered that block of ice. So step away from the carbonite man and no one ends up in a grave.
Your name, now.
My name is of little importance. I'm here to relieve you of your burden. Whether that includes your own lives as well is up to you.
Looky, looky. If it ain't Slestak, your master be wanting the froze man to her. Too bad for you. It mine.
You two know each other.
To know Tumar is to hate Tumar.
That go true for you too, Slestak. If you don't flee, this be like killing two stone with one bird.
I'm such a fool. I'll never doubt Lord Barriss again. What do we do?
These gents look reasonable. We'll reason with them.
Tumar and his mates can't even spell reasonable.
All me gotta be able to spell is kill. K-Y-Y-Y-L.
He convinced me. I think Tumar can kill you, Slestak.
Very amusing. I do relish the opportunity to rid the world of Tumar and his drones. So I'll be with you presently, Instigator.
Come on, boys. We smash the talk from Slestak's big mouth now!
Well done. While they fight, my men and I will deliver the prisoner to Lord Barriss. Thank you for buying us time, my lord.
Lenklin informed me of the ambush at the cargo port. Apparently there are more eyes on us than even I thought.
I have felt a disturbance in the Force. It leaves doom imprinted on my dreams. A grave and mysterious threat that could bring down my entire power base. This frozen man is a top Republic agent captured while investigating my most deeply embedded spy on Nar Shaddaa. One of my invisibles, the Force grants me a vision of doom. And immediately, my untraceable spy, who has left no footprints, no trail, is almost exposed. It makes me furious.
It could just be a coincidence, Master.
It is not coincidence. I can feel it. I must learn what tipped off the Republic agent. He is the key to uncovering the nature of this threat.
Now, while I thaw the prisoner and painfully siphon every morsel of information I can from him, I have some concerns that require your special talents.
Tell me what I must do.
No rest for the wicked, I guess.
Go to the Imperial post in the jungles outside the city. Commander Pritch is stationed there. He has a seek and destroy task for you.
It'll be done before you know it.
I must tend to the torturing of this miserable Republic agent.
Waste no time. I have more for you to do once this is complete. You are dismissed.
Commander Pritch at your service, my lord. Lord Barriss informed me you'd be paying us a visit. I'm prepared to offer full assistance.
Aren't you a good little soldier?
Lord Barriss has always found me, Sir Lord. Permit me to update you on the situation here. There's been much unrest in these parts recently, my lord, capped off by a violent slave revolt that has the surrounding jungles overrun with armed slaves.
Then they're not slaves anymore, are they?
I stand corrected, my lord. Former slaves. What no one knows is that Lord Barriss orchestrated the insurgents to disrupt one of his rivals, and he wants his involvement kept secret. Now the slave captains who led the revolt are threatening to expose Barriss's involvement unless they receive more potent weapons.
Continue, Commander.
Lord Barriss wants you to kill enough of the blackmailing slave captains to make the others lose their resolve.
Violence is not always the answer.
Well, I suppose. Many of these slave captains are former criminals with ties to the underworld. In fact, some have been selling their fellow slaves to the black market. If their followers found out, they'd be furious. If I had proof that they're selling their own people back into slavery, I could blackmail the slave captains to stop blackmailing Lord Barriss.
Blackmailing blackmailers? Sounds poetic.
I bet they keep records of their transactions. If you rifle the slave captains' footlockers and find proof, I'll do what I can to use it against them.
It's worth a try.
However you want to deal with it, my lord. The slave captains have their home base around the unfinished Colossus. I'll await any proof you salvage from the slave captain's belongings. My lord, you're back. Did you find sufficient proof that the slave captains are selling their people back into slavery?
The slave captains kept logbooks.
Most impressive, my lord. I can see why Lord Barriss has such faith in you. Now I can threaten to expose the truth. If the slave captains don't want to be torn limb from limb, they'll stop blackmailing Lord Barriss. I must stay, my lord. It's been inspiring watching you work.
You've been very helpful, Commander.
Thank you, Lord. I'm pleased to hear that. I'll inform Lord Barriss that the situation has been handled.
I don't care what you do. Break my bones, burn my flesh. I'll tell you nothing.
I will not be denied.
Go spit, you monster!
I didn't know bodies could bend like that. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Spare yourself. You shouldn't have to see this.
Ah, apprentice, you've returned. Commander Pritch confirmed that the slaves have been silenced. Good. I'm still trying to extract the information I crave from this Republic agent. He is much more resilient than anticipated.
He'll crack, Master. I'm sure of it.
I will not rest until he does. I have another important task for you. It involves a renegade Sith Lord named Grathan. A particularly bothersome thorn in my side. Meet with my apprentice, Dreykul Ball. He's my covert operative in Gratham's compound. Ball claims to have made a key discovery.
Do you know the nature of this discovery?
Ball only communicates in predetermined signals. He was to find Gratham's exploitable weakness, and today he sent the success signal. Gratham's presence is useful to me, so I don't want him killed, just crippled. Find out what Ball has discovered, and do exactly as he instructs.
Is your other apprentice above me in the pecking order?
I'm sure he views himself as your better. But he has merely been here longer. Now then, Republic wretch, where were we? Oh, yes. Tell me what I wish to know.
You must be the operative Lord Barriss sent. I thought he'd choose a stealthy assassin, not some senseless savage.
Just tell me the situation here.
Fine. I'll rise above my discontent. For now, listen. Lord Grathan is a rogue Sith who boldly defies the Dark Council. Locked away here, he's been untouchable. Lord Barriss wants to let Grathan know he can be reached. And after a year undercover, I've discovered the way. Lord Grathan has a son.
What does that have to do with anything?
I was assigned to find Grathan's weakness. He's kept his son a secret in order to protect him from his enemies. Grathan would be devastated if his only child and heir was dead. That would send a message.
I'm no baby killer.
We're not talking about a baby here. Grathan's kid is nearly 20 and strong with the Force. He's been trained in the ways of the Sith since birth. You'll have your hands full.
I highly doubt it.
All right. Maybe underestimating your foes works for you. Grathan's away on business. I managed to hack a special spike that will get you inside his private quarters. But first you're going to have to knock out Grathan's surveillance station so you aren't seen entering the quarters.
Tell me what that entails.
All you have to do is locate the monitoring stations around the compound and, well, stick your lightsaber in them. Think you can handle that, brute?
I will handle it.
That's all then. Destroy the monitoring stations, then get inside Grathan's private quarters. The son's name is Beelzlit. Find him and end him. I'll meet you back here when you're done. Try not to screw up.
I kinda like his attitude.
Mother, a stranger approaches.
You don't know the half of it, kid.
I am Sylvanta Grathan. How dare you enter my son's room uninvited? Who are you?
Step aside, woman. I'm here for the boy.
You'll have to kill me first. And while my son is still an acolyte, I am fully Sith.
Then we have something in common, Sylvanta.
Then may the Force give me the strength to defeat you. Beelzlit, take cover.
No, Mother! I stand at your side! Attack!
Nobody better mess with us now.
Stop! You are more than a match for us! Mother, if I am the target, save yourself! I don't want to see you die!
My son, you must not sacrifice yourself for anyone, not even me. You must endure at all costs. Assassin, you've carved your way into the inner sanctum of Lord Grathan's compound, all to kill a boy. You are a breath away from the Master himself. Spare us, and I'll help you destroy Lord Grathan instead.
You want me to kill your husband? Aren't you the dutiful wife?
I married Lord Grathan for power. It was a means to an end. Now I want out. I'm strong, but can't touch my husband. How long I've waited for someone to end his oppressive rule.
Grathan must live.
And so he shall. Just hear me out. A wicked plan is taking shape. Long ago, my husband was nearly beheaded. Now he cannot exist without his helmeted mask. Everyone knows this. Kill Lord Grathan. My son will wear the mask and assume his mantle. He'll publicly rant that his son was murdered. No one will be the wiser.
Fine. I'll kill the father instead.
Excellent. You won't regret it. Lord Grathan deserves to die. With this pass card, you may enter Lord Grathan's secret chamber. You'll find him there. After you've ended Lord Grathan's miserable existence, bring his masked helmet to me.
Be sure there are no surprises when I return.
I'm certainly not interested in angering someone as lethal as you. Besides, you're doing me a great service. Be wary of Lord Grathan. There are few as attuned to the dark side as he.
I don't think I like the sound of that.
My uninvited guest finally arrives. Your feelings betray you, youngster. I sensed your murderous intentions the moment you entered my sanctum. What's more, your unshielded mind has revealed your accomplice, my loving wife.
She sends her love?
Sylvanta is a user, child. She's obsessed with power. It's one of the things that attracted me to her. But it's outgrown its amusement. I am death itself, child. Come embrace the darkness.
Yes, I sensed my husband's death. Lord Grathen is no more. What pleasure to think he suffered.
He got what he deserved.
Mother, what does this mean? Am I truly to become the master of this house?
You will wear his mask and assume his identity. But you are not yet ready to rule, my dear. The voice will be yours, but the words will be mine.
I have longed for my father's death and the chance to claim his power.
Yes, this is a great day. You have served us well, my new friend.
I didn't do it for you.
I don't care why you did it, as long as it's done. For appearance sake, you'll still be unwelcome here. But today, my son and I have become your secret allies.
As soon as I leave, we are enemies again.
I would expect nothing else. Now leave me. I have much to do now that I control House Grathen.
I'm surprised you survived. So is it done? Is Grathen's son dead?
You're a condescending windbag, Baal.
It's pretty easy to push your buttons, Brute. Doesn't say much for Grathen's security forces if a clumsy clod like you was able to bang into his private chamber and off his son.
I find your empty chatter amusing.
You'll find my lightsaber a bit sobering. Killing the murderer of Grathen's son will solidify my cover here. Barriss can replace you easily.
You're making a big mistake.
Though I'm more than capable of facing you alone, a smart man uses every advantage. And I am a smart man.
The intruder! The intruder is here! Everyone to me! Attack!
Nice lungs you got there.
Mind your tongue, or I will cut it out!
Okay, I'm officially scared.
This is impossible. An unknown power must be shielding this man, which only confirms my suspicions. This Republic agent is the key to unlocking the threat we face. I must harness my rage and frustration. They will lead me to an answer!
Trust your feelings, Master.
The minion advises the Master. Very good. You demonstrate your progress. And the word has spread that Lord Grathen is incensed at the slaying of his secret son. I take it that was your handiwork?
You see it correctly.
My confidence in you is growing. I haven't heard from Dreykul Ball, my agent in Grathen's camp. He's missed a scheduled communication. Let me guess. He gave you trouble, did he?
He left me no choice, Master. I had to kill him.
Oh, no matter. He fulfilled his primary purpose. Every Sith must attempt to orchestrate his own promotion. Now, back to my prisoner. There's one last possibility to break him. I thought it impossible, but perhaps there's a small chance you could pull it off. Over a millennium past, the Emperor claimed Drummond Kass and made the Dark Temple the epicenter of Dark Force energy. In the bowels of the temple, he conducted horrifying experiments that drained the knowledge and life essence from all the greatest Sith lords of the time.
He destroyed his own lords.
They existed to serve their master, and that they did. He siphoned them to make himself immortal and all-knowing. The Emperor created a device called the Ravager that ate his victims' minds and delivered to him their greatest secrets. No one could withstand the Ravager's intrusion. Even the strongest Sith lords of the Empire confessed whatever the Emperor craved.
Where can the Ravager be found?
The Emperor keeps the Ravager hidden in the Dark Temple, which has, in his absence, become a death trap.
There's a good chance the horrors that await you will be too severe. But it's worth your life to me. The legends describe a secret chamber in the depths of the Dark Temple where the Ravager was encased. You'll know the device by its inscription. Be swift, apprentice.
It was foolish of you to return here.
Uh-oh. Looks like we got another fight on our hands.
Those pieces you took from my minions belong to me. They will enable me to exact my revenge on Lord Farshall. I am Lord Vacuous, the conqueror of Begeron, the killer of Garatak the Singed. Return what you have stolen or burn.
You don't look like a Sith to me.
Perhaps your vision will improve in death.
I sent you into the Dark Temple for the Ravager. I thought it might be the last time I saw you, apprentice. The prisoner grows weaker by the minute. There's no time to spare. Stand back and bear witness.
You're wasting your time. I will not.
Yes, the Ravager has seized his mind. Excellent. In his condition, we don't have long before the ordeal liquefies all brain matter.
Maybe he'll last longer if you reduce the pain.
The pain drives the device's effectiveness. Republic Worm, you have the information I desire. Tell me everything.
I am Republic Information Service, on special assignment to verify possible Imperial spy on Nar Shaddaa, commissioned by Jedi Council, acting on suspicions provided by Master Nomen Kar.
Nomen Kar. That's a name I grow tired of hearing.
One of your enemies, I take it.
My oldest and most hated enemy. An old wound that continues to fester. Nomen Kar is a Jedi Master who infiltrated the Sith. I rooted him out. Then he nearly destroyed me and fled. He's dedicated himself to proving that the Sith have spies embedded within Republic and Jedi ranks. I've thwarted him at every turn, but he is tenacious. How did Nomen Kar come to suspect my spy on Nar Shaddaa? Tell me, Republic wretch, what alerted him?
Master, Nomen Kar has a new Padawan. She seems to know any beings. True nature, she senses hidden darkness and untapped purity.
Astonishing. I've never heard of the Force granting such a gift. Tell me, how does her power work?
All I know is when Master Nomen Kar brought her to Nar Shaddaa, this Padawan sensed darkness in your spy simply by seeing him.
What's a Padawan?
That is what the Jedi call their trainees. It means she is not yet a Jedi.
If this young Padawan can see through deception and disguise with such little effort, she threatens everything I have worked for. Continue, Republic dog.
Char believes his Padawan's ability is foolproof. But the Jedi Council is skeptical. I was to provide the proof, but I wasn't able to report my findings.
We must know more about this Padawan.
Yes, my apprentice. Such a threat must not wander the galaxy unchecked. Who is this Padawan, you Republic pest? Tell me everything you know about her.
She was found on Alderaan. Her power first emerged, training on Tatooine. And Jedi sent another agent to investigate someone she suspected on Balmora.
It's fading. Is she human or one of the Jedi's cursed aliens? Where can I find her? What is her name?
I have nothing more.
The Ravager has emptied his mind. That is all we have to go on. A few random places within the greater galaxy where Noman Carr and his Padawan have been.
It's a start, Master. That device did the trick.
You are correct. We now have leads to follow. Noman Carr is a relentless crusader, and this Padawan and her unprecedented power threaten everything I have achieved. Your duties are likely to take you to the far reaches of the galaxy. I will need to deploy you at will. You shall have a starship of your own. You've earned it. Go to my personal hangar in the spaceport and claim it.
You are most generous, Master.
Save your gratitude. I must ponder our next move. Waste no time. Get your starship in my hangar and wait for further instructions.
Yeah, let's go before he tells me to clean all this up. Okay? You know, I was a slave when I was a little girl. Before I got free. Sort of full circle, I guess.
You work for a Sith, as all in the Empire do, but your collar has been removed.
Right. I do appreciate the difference, believe me. My mother and sister and I were grabbed when I was little. I don't remember much of it. We worked the mines on Ryloth. Then they separated us. I got sold to a Rodian, then a Hutt. Then some sort of weird three-eyed thing.
All of this while you were still a child?
Yeah, I was 7 or 8 by the time I landed with Three Eyes. Anyway, I guess you know you've moved around too much when a Sith ship starts to feel like home.
This is home. And this is our strange little community.
I guess you're right. Watch out, I don't start calling you Pops. Take a look at that. We're going in style now.
Nice ship. Are you leaving, Dromund Kaas?
Your name, now.
Relax. I'm a friend. Bearing gifts. Sylventa Grathan sent me to deliver this token of her appreciation for all you've done for her. It will greatly enhance this new ship of yours.
Does she usually send a Sith to deliver a gift?
Very good. No, that's not the typical M.O. I'm here on behalf of Sylventa's husband, Lord Grathan, who has added his own present to the offering. He claims you know too much.
Sylventa needs to get her house in order.
Are you mad? Lady Grathan doesn't control the household. I answer only to Lord Grathan. I've murdered just about every form of sentient being in the galaxy, and I'm here for you.
greetings. I am 2VR8, that totem droid for this vessel. You must be my new master. Gentle, kind new master.
So, I get a starship and a servant too. Not bad at all.
I am relieved, pleased that you find me agreeable. I will never disappoint you, Master. I am programmed for a wide array of tasks, including but not limited to meal preparation, ship maintenance, janitorial duty, and etiquette. Welcome aboard this Fury-class Imperial Interceptor, a versatile craft combining a starfighter's maneuverability with armament to rival larger military vessels. You'll find all of the standard amenities, including your own private captain's locker for storing valuables. The astrogation console contains a constantly updated map of the known galaxy. Interstellar communications are accessed via the ship's holoterminal. Priority alerts that you may find useful are available from the Imperial Holonet console. Lastly, the ship's intercom will inform your crew that you wish to issue new orders. Any questions, Master?
I have a mission to complete. Time to see what this ship can do.
Thank goodness you aren't deactivating me. Good luck. I regret I am unable to offer you combat support, Master. Frankly, my chassis couldn't withstand the stress. However, should any errands arise that are beneath your superior status, please do not hesitate to call upon me. I function to serve you. Whenever you are ready to depart, consult the galaxy map on your bridge. It will program the proper astrogation coordinates and activate the engines.
Apprentice, I trust you find your starship satisfactory?
It's an outstanding vessel.
I hope that it serves you well. There is much to be done. My interests must be protected, and my enemies destroyed. Noman Carr's efforts to expose my spies and prove his Padawan's power to the Jedi Council must meet with systemic failure. You will exhaust yourself in this charge.
Where do you suggest I begin?
The information we siphoned from that Republic agent will be our map. We know my spy on Na Shadar was being surveilled. We know where this Padawan was discovered, where she trained, and that the Jedi have sent someone to investigate my spy on Balmora. The Padawan will have to be hunted down and destroyed, but first you must secure my network by silencing my spies on Balmora and Na Shadar.
Why not simply recall your spies?
Their disappearance would look suspicious and serve to confirm the Padawan's accusations. My spies must die. My contacts on Balmora and Na Shadar will detail what must be done. Your tasks are paramount, Apprentice. Bring cruelty. Bring rage. Bring death.